I was just to pick up where I left off my talk with the paraphrase of the Phaedrus and the Plato. To a little myth there of the inventor of writing coming to the king of Egypt and saying, look at this wonderful thing I built, along with the other things I built and simulated and experimented with. Plato said, this is no good. People no longer need to remember things, and therefore they will no longer be wise here because they have offloaded that to the book. Something of the same kind of dread is what you're expressing here. But let me project this out in the future. Let's imagine 150 to 500 years from now, some parent saying to their kid, I'm concerned that you'll lose the talent for modular and loosely coupled knowledge. The ability to quarantine your concerns and issues in nice object-oriented kinds of programming modules here, which after all have a certain ability to project an image of emancipation. What do we want in the world? You know, it's just not true that we want information to be free. We want people to be free. And I hate to say this at a history conference, but part of what that has always meant is people should be free to choose or to be emancipated from their history. To be emancipated from their history means to have the maneuver to be able to break out of relationship with a whole linear sequence of events, contingencies, and people, to be that free-floating sort of packet of modular information here. So I can see in the future somebody having the same kind of dread of the loss of freedom that information makes possible in ways that were not possible before.